If you're watching online, because we've already started streaming, if you're watching online, please fill out our attendance card and let us know that you're here. Well, I guess it doesn't matter where I wear white or black. I spilled my water. You all are in for a treat. I never have coffee, and I had coffee. This side of the church is about to fall over. Yeah, y'all looking over there? See that? Oh my goodness, what happened? Are we giving something out over on this side? We must be. Welcome. I am glad all. Sounded like I was cutting out. Glad that you're all here. I'm Pastor Doug, and we are going to have a great worship service today. And if you didn't hear, we have Ash Wednesday coming up, so come on back and let's see you on Wednesday at 5 o'clock here and 7 o'clock in Casa Grande, and you're going to hear that again, but we just had some people come in that weren't able to stay, and they wanted to know when Ash Wednesday was, so it's been on my brain. Thanks for being here. Please stand as you're able. We'll continue with the confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who sends the word with angels, who is made flesh among all peoples, and who breathes peace on all the earth. In Christ, we are bold to name our sin and cry out for peace. Holy God, we confess our sin before you. With replace our compassion with competition. We seek what is mighty while ignoring the meek. We are quick to anger, but slow to forgive. We have not put on love in harmony with you. Wrap us in this grace of powerful world. Swaddle our hearts with your peace, that all we do in word or deed may reflect your love born among us. Amen. People, I bring good news of great joy for all people. God has come among us in the child born of Mary, Christ the Lord. In Christ, your sins are forgiven, and you are clothed in peace. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Please share that peace with one another. Peace to everyone at home. We're going to continue with our opening hymn, Shine, Jesus, Shine. the grace of God, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray together. Radiant God, you revealed yourself in your Son, Jesus, when he was transfigured on the mountain before his disciples. Reveal yourself to us daily so that we might enlighten others with the good news of your love. We pray these things in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated for today's lessons.
Our reading for today is from Psalm 41, verses 7 to 10. All my enemies whisper together against me. They imagine the worst of me, saying, "The vile disease has afflicted him, and he will never get up from the place where he lies." Even my close friend, someone I trusted, one who shared my bread, has turned against me. But may you have mercy on me, Lord. Raise me up that I may repay them. Here ends the psalm.
Please stand as you're able. We'll continue with thy word. Our gospel reading today is taken from Matthew chapter 16, beginning at verse 24 and running through chapter 17, verse 8. The Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Then Jesus said to his disciples, "Whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For whoever wants to save their life will lose it, but whoever loses their life for me will find it. What good would it be for someone to gain the whole world yet forfeit their soul? Or what can anyone give in exchange for their soul? For the Son of Man is going to come in his Father's glory with his angels, and then he will reward each person according to what they have done. Truly, I tell you, some who are standing here will not taste death before they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. After 6 days, Jesus took with him Peter, James, and John, the brother of James, and led them up a high mountain by themselves. There he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became as white as the light. Just then there appeared before them Moses and Elijah talking with Jesus. Peter said to Jesus, Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you wish, I will put up three shelters, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. While he was still speaking, a bright cloud covered them, and a voice from the cloud said, This is my Son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased. Listen to him. When the disciples heard this, they fell face down towards the ground, terrified. But Jesus came to them and touched them. Get up, he said. Don't be afraid. When they looked up, they saw no one except Jesus. The gospel of our Lord.
Praise you, O Christ.
Please be seated. It's funny sometimes how the phones, when they do go off at the right time in a reading, isn't it? So if you haven't done so, go ahead and silence those cell phones, unless you are expecting a phone call from God or a tweet. I used to call it twit. I didn't know it was tweet. It's Twitter. It should be a twit, right? Just saying. Or is it those of us who use it are the twits? And there's some people on there you would think they are. Transfiguration is an awesome thing, and Peter and the rest of them were scared when they saw what really happened. They stumbled with their words and like, we'll make tents and we're going to stay here. Because part of it, I think, was maybe they're like excited and let's be in this the whole time. And then God spoke, and then they became terrified. But Jesus says, don't be afraid, be calm. This is a whole lot different of what goes on in our gospel beforehand and even before these verses that we heard. So let's put all this in context. In verse 15, which you did not hear, Jesus asked Peter, who am I? Because they're going through this conversation. Some people say that you're Elijah. Some say that you're Moses. Some say you're this, John the Baptist. Some say you're this, you're this, you're this. Everybody had opinions. But Jesus wanted to know who Peter thought he was. So Simon Peter answered, you are the Messiah, the Son of the living God. And Jesus compliments him, saying, you get it right, but it wasn't you that figured that out. It was God who told you who I am. So it wasn't by his own power that he understood, just like our faith is not by our own power, it is through the Holy Spirit. But then he follows up and he says, by the way, I'm going to die. And it's not going to be an easy death. I'm going to be tortured. I'm going to have suffering. I am going to die. But then I am going to come back. Now, can you imagine, Peter? Wait a second, you're the Messiah. And then you're going to die. So what does Peter do? He rebukes him. He says, no, this ain't possible. This ain't going to happen, no. And Jesus says, "Stand behind me, Satan." Peter, you're a great person. You figured it all out. Not on your own, but you figured it all out. And now he says, "Stand behind me, Satan." Wow, we're going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Sounds a little bit like our own lives, isn't it? Sometimes we do good, sometimes we don't. Sometimes things are going great, sometimes it isn't. Sometimes we take 2 steps forward and 10 steps backwards. Poor Peter didn't know which way to turn. But then it gets even more interesting with our reading. He tells people, them and you, to be one of his disciples, you must give up your life. To be a disciple, be a follower of Jesus, you must pick up your cross. The cross is not a pretty thing. Oh, that one's pretty. It's so much easier to talk about God's love, isn't it? It's much more comfortable to talk about the love that God has for us in Jesus. But the reality is, if you look up on the screen, that is what the cross is. That is Jesus, the man and God who allowed himself to be hung on that cross for you, for me. That's the gruesome reality of following Jesus. Because it may mean one of us, whether by words or physically, may die. Words can kill as well. Anybody had bad things said to them and they felt like, "I'd rather die than hear those things"? Oh, come on. I know there's others. Yeah. Let's be honest. Words hurt. Words hurt. But sometimes following Jesus means that people will say things and do things that are very uncomfortable to those that are following Jesus. So let's just talk about the love, right? Nah, we're not going to do that. It would have been easy, because we had these 2 sections of text, just to talk about, wow, the awesomeness of God, the awesomeness of Jesus being transfigured. Isn't this great? And today is Transfiguration Day. That's the easy text. The hard text is talking about picking up our cross. What we do matters. What Jesus did mattered. His flesh torn away for you and me. His hands bloodied and nailed to a cross. Beaten to an inch of his life matters. I can see the uncomfortable faces. We need to be uncomfortable sometimes, because this is the reality of a God that we have that will do anything for us. What are we willing to do in response? Or do we just want to have the clean love part? I'm not trying to make this to be a drag. God does love us. Otherwise, God would not have done what God did. That's the good news. That's the great news. There is no better news than that, that we have a God that will go to the cross and die for us. That should make every one of you smile and happy, because that is the God that we have. There are no other gods, no other gods. There's no other religion that has a God that will die for them. It has never happened because this is the one true God who died, descended into hell, so that there's no place at all where God is not present. And anybody ever feel so low that it felt like you were walking through hell? I have. Yeah. God's there. Jesus is there with you, walking alongside you all the time. Jesus is always present. The Holy Spirit was sent to make sure that God is there. Do you believe that God is always with you? Do you really believe that God is with you? That is God's love with you. Because of that. Because of that. This. And picking up our cross. And dying so that we have life. These are the conditions of discipleship. These are the conditions of discipleship. So even when things are said that may not be true about you, know that God knows the truth and God loves you. When we're going down that road that may seem murky, that may seem like a desert, and you're going, I really don't want to be on this desert road, that you aren't alone on that desert road. That God is with you on that desert road. You will not be left alone. That is the good news, because God loves you that much. Sometimes it's difficult to see God with all the dust kicked up that we're kicking a lot of times by ourselves because we don't like what we're in. But God's still going, I'm here. Don't worry. I got you. I have your back. You are loved. You are mine. I call you by name. I will never abandon you. I do not break promises. I died for you so that you may always have eternal life. How will we respond? Please stand as you're able as we sing, Seek Ye First. This confession, the Nicene Creed, says what we believe as Christians. So when we speak these words, this is what we say that we believe. This is what we accept as truth. So let us confess our faith as written in the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Please be seated. Thanks, George. I need that. He brought it up just for me. So if you didn't hear, we have Ash Wednesday coming up. Also, if you weren't able to get an opportunity to turn in your intent cards back on January 29th, please see an usher and they can give you another card and you can turn that in. You can do that online or you can send it through the postal mail. So we're receiving it multiple different ways. We're going to take up the offering as well right now. If you haven't filled out your attendance cards, please do so as a reminder. And I know I should have said it up front, but it's on the bulletin. Please print. I have a hard time reading cursive. And let's face it, if you had to read what I wrote in cursive, you'd have a hard time too. So, if you are an associate member and you would like to turn your membership to a senior, seasonal member, please let me know. If you are a winter resident here and you would like to be an associate or seasonal member as well, please let me know. We're going to be having soon some membership classes, and it's simple. There's a test. Can you get there? We're going to go over Luther's small catechism, and it'll just be a one-day class. Just make sure that you're Lutheranized a little. If please check the prayer list. Our prayer list has grown long, which is not a bad thing, but it's also a bad thing. Because it means a lot of people need prayer, but that's also a good thing that we can do that and lift people up in prayer. Amazon shopping list, so if you are willing to purchase what's out there right now, we have some paper out there as an addition to your normal giving. We'd really appreciate it. Just purchase it, have it come to your place, and bring it in on Sunday, and we'll put that to use. We need a couple people to help out with altar care. So there's an opportunity now for some people to help out with altar care, but more than a couple. It would be great if we had 12 people. It would be great if we had 24 people. Because sometimes those things aren't so easy to change. It takes two people. It takes help. But it also means that every one of us can help out with that. You don't have to be on altar care. You have to be available when somebody says, I need help. That's all it is. If you're in the spiritual gifts class that we have right now, you probably already know if you have the gift of helping. But I bet you many of you already know that. That's how all this stuff gets done, is by people setting that up. So even at Easter and at Christmas, other people can get involved. And so Dell, raise your hand for a second. Right now Dell is going to be doing this, but she needs help. You're going to help her a little, right? You're going to cheer her on. Okay. Just want to make sure you're cheering her on. But please see Dell. The help is for here, this side, okay? So we need to make sure that these things get done. The busiest time, okay, starts right now. Because we switched to white, then we're going to be switching to purple on Wednesday, then we're going to stay purple for a while, not very long, and then we're going to turn into white again on Monday, Thursday, we're going to turn to black on Good Friday, the altar will be stripped, and then it goes all back to white and all the Easter stuff comes up. This is the busiest time. Most of the time, we're in green, common time. So that one's the easy one. But this is where extra hands could be helpful. So please see her and let you know. We're also still looking for people to help out right for fellowship. So raise your hand. Karen would like more help. Karen would like more help, okay? Another opportunity for people to help out. It's really, really involved, right?
Yeah, it's not too hard.
Oh, it's not too hard? You mean make some coffee, throw out some snacks and goodies? All right, right. The other thing is, and you'll hear this, and you may have not caught this, but Susan is in the hospital right now, and she has cancer surgery tomorrow. That's Paul Garrison's wife. I talked to Paul, and he's okay with me. Sorry. I don't like to see anybody sick. But right now, this is a burden on Paul as well. If you can see Paul, he could use your help here. He could use your help at home. Susan needs prayers. They left here last Sunday because she wasn't looking good, and she's been in the hospital for a week and having surgery tomorrow. See how you can help Paul out, whether it's here or making some meals, and you expect her home very soon. So that means she's not going to be getting up and doing all the cooking. So he could use some meals for both of them. We have a giving, helping congregation. Help. See Paul. I know that you can help. The rest of the stuff's on here. We have a council meeting on Tuesday. And those of you that are signed up for tidbits, and if you aren't, please consider doing so. But we're going to have a Casa Grande dialogue over in Casa Grande following worship, talking about the effects of the budget and what happens over there, but we're going to also have that same dialogue over here next week. You're all invited to come over to Casa Grande and be part of that, but we'll also have one here where we'll invite people from Casa Grande to come over here early to be part of that as well. So quite honestly, when we do combine things, we seem to have less people overall, so we're splitting that up so that we can have the maximum amount of people involved in that dialogue. Am I missing, because I tend to miss things when I have a lot going on, am I missing any announcements? Okay, not hearing any. Please stand as you're able, and we'll continue with the offering song and prayer. Let us pray together. Liberating God, you break the bonds of injustice and let the oppressed go free. Receive these offerings in thanksgiving for all your works of merciful power, and shape us as a people of your justice and freedom. You can magnify and adore through Jesus Christ, Savior. Amen. Let us continue with Let the Vineyards. Called together to follow Jesus, we pray for the church, the world, and all in need. Embolden your church as it witnesses to the majesty and mercy of your Son. Equip lay preachers, deacons, and pastors. Move us to share our stories of your faithfulness and forgiveness. May our lives proclaim your greatness. Merciful God, receive our prayers. Dwell with your whole creation. From the tallest mountain peak to the deepest valley, bless the work of conservation organizations and protect vital habitats. Support the work of disaster relief agencies around the world. Merciful God, receive our prayer. Guide and give wisdom to all in authority, our mayors, our local leaders, our governors, state legislations, our president, and national legislators. Bring freedom and justice to all nations. Merciful God, receive our prayer. Give shelter to those lacking safe homes. Spur communities to work for fair housing for all. Protect our neighbors whose dwellings do not keep out dangers of cold or heat. Accompany with your touch those who are homebound, sick, or isolated. Merciful God, receive our prayer. Make us eager to receive your word in Scripture. Help us to recognize Jesus' voice in the needs of our neighbors. Make us confident to follow the way of the cross. Merciful God, receive our prayer. Compassionate and healing God, we ask that you be with all those on our prayer list, providing everything that they need and for their caregivers as well. So today we lift up to you Arlen B., Amy, Asher, Azur, baby Joseph and Amy, Becky S., Bob, Bruce H., Bunny D., Dale C., Dan I., Debbie and family, Edward, Diane, Dick, Erica D., Francis L., Fred D., Gary I., Gina D., Gracie T., Janelle J., Janet, Jason F., Jerry R., Joseph, Joe S., Jordan, Julie, Kathy D., Kimmy, Mark G. family, Mary L., Nancy, Neil B. family, Nikki, Ryan, Riley, R., Robin, Ryan D., Ron and Sandy C., Susan G., Cactus Middle School, Choyoa Elementary, Ironwood Elementary, Arizona Elementary, Casa Grande Police and Fire, Pinell County Sheriff's Office, and all those that we now say silently in our heart or out loud to carry them out to you, Lord. Waco, Savita, Hamanita, Jai, Bobby, Becky, First Lutheran, Central Lutheran, Grand Canyon Synod. Merciful God, receive our prayer. receive our thanksgiving for the holy ones who have guided us in faithfulness and gathered even the unlikely as your people. With your forebears in faith and all who have hoped in you, teach us to wait with courage until the promised day dawns. Merciful God, receive our prayer. We bring to you our needs, our hopes, O God, trusting your wisdom and power revealed in Christ crucified. Amen. In the night in which our Lord Jesus was crucified, he took bread, he gave thanks, breaking it. He gave it to his disciples and said to them, and he's saying to you, take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After supper, took the cup, gave thanks, giving it to his disciples. And again, to you, he says, take and drink of this, all of you. This is a new covenant shed in my blood for the forgiveness of sins of all people. Do this in remembrance of me. For as often as we eat of this bread and we drink of this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes again. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us now pray as our Lord Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come and taste the joy of God. Please be seated. Come forward at the usher's direction. I will need two more communion assistants, and I need one more. Thank you. Not to burst your bubble, Mary, but let's try something a little bit different today that I was told about at another congregation I think will work out. Okay. Come forward when you are ready. Okay. Grape juice is in the middle. And wine is on the outside. All bread is gluten-free.
One cup of blessing
One cup of blessing which we bless, and with the many throughout the earth, we are one body in this one Lord. Many the gifts.
Please stand as you're able. Let us pray. Holy One, we thank you for the healing that springs forth abundantly from this table. Renew our strength to do justice, love kindness, and journey humbly with you and take up our cross. Amen. The God who faithfully brings forth justice and breaks the oppressor's rod, bless, strengthen, and uphold you today and always. Amen. Amen. Let us go out singing, Blessed Are They.
Shall be
Go in peace. Follow the way of Jesus.
Thanks.
Have some fellowship time or come on over and be part of the dialogue over in Casa Grande. Either are good. See you later.